when we make the bell, we first make the design. For the orchestra, we made a special design because it had to be a major third bell instead of a traditional minor third bell. So you can see here the difference between the two is actually the bell itself. And you can see it's a little bit thicker at the bottom and a little bit thinner at the top. With the inner stricle, we make the core, as we call it. So when the sand has become hard, we add the outer stricle. We will fill this gap with wax. Later on, we will add decoration and inscriptions, like a Symphony Orchestra Luxembourg, the decoration of the flag and the upper and lower decoration. We will cover it with a kind of a coating. We will put a steel case around it and fill the steel case with sand. And when the sand has become solid again, we have a mirror shape of the false bell in this core. When we remove the wax, we can put the steel case over the core again, and then it will be filled with bronze. So after the bell has been cooled down until about 150 degrees, which takes about 2 days for this bell, and we can remove the mold. We have a tuning machine there. We put the bells upside down, and with a chisel, we cut the inside from the bell on different levels, making sure that the overtones of the bell will be perfectly in pitch.
C'est formidable, on présente notre nouvel instrument, qui est une cloche d'église. Ce qui est intéressant, c'est d'être dans une salle de concert et se dire que, en fin de compte, on donne un message. C'est annoncer quelque chose et c'est le point culminant de la pièce, c'est le moment où sacral, vraiment sacral. L'important surtout, c'est de partager, qu'on partage ensemble ce moment inoubliable. Tous ensemble. Et c'est ça qu'on veut et on est très très heureux surtout.